Hey there, in this video I'm going to show you how to customize your Dr. Racket application for your own liking. Since Dr. Racket is pretty similar on each platform, other than some keystrokes and toolbar menu options, we will try to cover each platform in one video and noting the differences. Let's begin by opening up Dr. Racket and letting it load. Alright, it looks like Dr. Racket has fully loaded. Let's full screen that, and wow, that font is very small. Let's make it bigger by pressing Ctrl plus multiple times, or flower key equal sign if you're on the Mac. To start programming, we need to first choose a language. Right-click here, click on Choose Language, Teaching Languages, and Intermediate Student with Lambda. The language button is now highlighted yellow because we haven't run our program yet to load the language. There you go. I like to always switch to vertical layout by right-clicking the middle bar in the screen. This is because if you have a longer program, you can read more text on screen at once, and also if you have a lot of interactions. Okay, let's see if we're actually able to run a Racket program. Imagine that you'd like to play with some sample code you found on a website. Instinctively, you might just left-click on it and whoa, you're greeted with this extra text at the top of the page that's not really part of the program. To get around this, we have to make sure we actually download the file correctly by right-clicking the link, save link as, and put it in a folder somewhere on your hard drive. Once that's all finished, we can exit our internet browser, return back to Dr. Racket, file, open, and navigate to where you saved the file. There you go. Now that we have an active program open, let's see if we can change some preferences under the Edit menu. If you are running the Mac platform, the Preferences menu will be under the Dr. Racket menu on the very left side. In the Font tab of the Preferences, you can change various things, like the font size, or the font name to any of these that are listed. You could also change the font smoothing, but we recommend that you keep it at the default setting, Use System-Wide Default. In the Colors tab, you can do some other cool things. You can change the whole color scheme to something like white on black. Interesting. Or you can go back to black on white. You can also do some custom modifications. You can change the background color to like green. Yummy. Under the Editing tab, there are some more useful options. Automatically adjust open square brackets is helpful when you're doing conditional statements. And another good one to have on is called Enable Automatic Parentheses, which helps you if you sometimes forget to add ending parentheses to your opening ones. Finally, under the Racket tab, make sure all of the options are selected. Now let's see what this program actually does. Clicking on Run and going back to the Interactions pane, we'll type in parenthesis hack 0, which is the base case. And look, we get a little picture of a hacker, but he's very small. If we type in hack 1, we're starting to see a triangle pattern. If we keep going, wow, it's getting bigger. Hack 3, okay, something is happening here, but this concept will be explained later in the course. Let's look at the code a bit more closely. If this is your first time seeing Dr. Racket code, notice that there's a lot of parentheses inside of other parentheses. This nested structure can be quite daunting at times, especially if you have a lot of expressions in one line, especially right here. Wow. To help yourself understand these long expressions, you can add a new line before every open parenthesis to spread things out a little bit. By doing this, we are helping ourselves visually understand what kind of nested structure is happening in these expressions. But there's a more visually appealing way, which was created by Gary Baumgartner of the University of Toronto. This file can be read by Dr. Racket as a package, and is available by clicking File, Install Package, and the link is as follows. By pressing OK, your Dr. Racket application will fetch the file and install it. I've already installed it, so you just click on Close when it's finished, and now you have to change some more settings. These settings can be found in the Preferences dialog, and under the Colors tab, choose the color scheme that you want for the parentheses. You'll see what these are later, but for now we're going to choose Shades of Blue. Okay. There's only one more setting we have to change. Under the View menu, choose Parentheses Range Highlight and click Rounded Box. Also, select all the other options, Horizontal Inset Boxes, Vertical Inset Boxes, and Outlined Rounded Box only. Immediately after changing the settings, you're going to start seeing some different shades of blue. The darker shades of blue represent the expressions that are more deeply nested than the expressions that are lighter. If we take a look at this function at the bottom of the page, you'll begin to see how well this tool can help us understand a very deeply nested function.